Caught Erica and Ryan in the act, and you guys, she is mad. Not only has Erica taken her company, but she's taken Ryan, and Ryan's like down with this. Greenlee's head is spinning, although not in that weird Linda Blair exorcist way. Anyway, Greenlee's out for revenge, and she begins concocting two plans that will target Erica and Ryan. First up, hurt Erica, who's running Fusion, you know, the company she started. So Greenlee sets out to totally destroy Fusion thanks to a handy computer virus that can wipe out everything the company owns. Sure, Fusion was her baby, but she'd rather see it die than run by Erica Kane. And that's not her only plan. Look for Greenlee to make a pretty huge request of David, one that's intended to make Ryan, and all of Pine Valley, drop their jaws. Greenlee's whole plot may be exposed sooner than she'd like because David, her partner in crime, is arousing major suspicion for Tad and Jake. They want to know why David's back in town, and they better not dig too deep or it'll lead them right to Green's. All this plus, Amanda gets freaked out by something Jake says, Jesse and Angie try to hash out their differences, Colby and Damon's friendship is making no one happy, and Crystal falls off the bed during sex. Yep, for real. Gang, say what you will about Mitch Lawrence and what an evil murderer he is, but that guy knows how to draw dozens of people to a creepy mountain hideaway. It's probably why he's such a good cult leader. Anyway, this week on One Life to Live, everyone is chasing after Mitch because he's still holding Jessica captive. Natalie and Brody bust John out of jail and head on up Mount Lantano, and so do Dorian and Charlie, who want to use Stacy as bait so they can kill Mitch. Yeah, it's a lot. Two things happen that kick things up a couple notches. First of all, it's crazy snowy, and John, Natalie, Brody, Dorian, Charlie, Fish, Rex, and Skylar are all heading to Lantano Mountain to find Stacy, Jessica, or both. Problems arise in the form of 3 car crashes and explosions, and Stacy ending up right in Mitch's grasp. Stacy is forced to play all her cards and tell Mitch her baby isn't really Mitch's grandchild. Mitch doesn't take that well. Basically, the whole population of Landview ends up on that mountain, and by the end of the week, half of them are near death. And yet, none of them are in as much danger as Jessica. Not only does Mitch want to erase her memory, but at the end of the week, he decides on a new plan to ensure his future with Jessica that may put him at number 1 in the baddest of bad guys Hall of Fame. So, did you guys see anything interesting Friday's episode? Oh, right. Sonny shot Dominic and then learned he's his son? Yeesh. It's high, high drama over there, and it's not going to let up this week. Dominic survives the shooting, but just barely. And in the meantime, look for Lulu to go on a total rampage on his behalf. Also, Carly finds out that Jax knew all about Dominic and was plotting to get Sonny sent to prison. That's the last straw for Carly, you guys, and she moves out. But the best part? Who she moves in with. Back to Sonny, though, for a second. He's got possible attempted murder charges facing him. Jason and Carly try to convince him that the best thing for everyone really is for him to leave the country. Can Sonny really leave Port Charles behind, though? And what will Dante have to say about this, especially once he comes face to face with Sonny, knowing it's his dad? Oh, and also, Michael spills the beans about killing Claudia to Christina and Morgan and Molly. Good thing kids are so good at keeping secrets. All this, plus Elizabeth has this huge meltdown at the hospital that gets her a fun, crazy lady vacation, and Robin's ticked off when she finds out Patrick knew about Dante all along.